Outlet. This week at Grocery Outlet, all-time favorite Kraft macaroni and cheese is buy two, get one free. Also, stop by for Silk unsweetened almond milk. 64-ounce containers are buy one, get one free.
Looking to sell your valuable coins, high-end jewelry, collectibles, or fine art? Dave has a word of caution.
Don't be fooled by the famous CD palm brokers. They don't pay anything.
Why listen to Dave?
I'm a coin dealer in San Diego.
Oh, so where does Dave go?
Tangible investments. I drive a 130-mile round trip to Tangible. Yeah, I go see Phil. I do it twice a week.
That's a lot of miles, and for good reason.
Coins, jewelry, diamonds, art, watches. Anything I've ever sold them, they pay me top dollar. They're super knowledgeable. I've been dealing with Tangible 20 years. Phil is a genius.
There's an easy way to prove Dave right.
Get two or three other bids and then go to Tangible. They definitely pay you the most.
Tangible Investments owner Syl DeGenova has become America's top dealer in coins, precious metals, jewelry, and fine art. And Syl guarantees you'll get more. Take Dave's advice.
If you want to go where the dealers go, go to Tangible.
Call now for a no-obligation, free professional appraisal. 800-711-2800. 800-711-2800. 800-711-2800.
Still loving those Solar Max panels, yeah?
I just wish I went Solar Max sooner. I'd be saving even more money.
Right now, you can get the Tesla 420 panels and power walls for $79.96 per month and zero down.
Dial #250 on your cell and say Solar Max or go to solarmaxtech.com. Monthly payment available on 2 credits. I guess it'll be number 97203.
Have you been wanting to give your home or apartment a fresh new look? Perhaps furnish an Airbnb. Or maybe you need help setting up your home office. Then come into Court Furniture Outlet today and discover why Court Furniture has been the secret destination for home stagers, designers, and savvy business professionals for over 40 years. You'll save on everything you need to brighten up your home or make your workplace more comfortable. And at Court Furniture Outlet, everything is in stock and ready for immediate delivery. New upholstery and several styles and colors, including sleeper sectionals with storage only $4.99. Conference tables and meshback office chairs from $59. And bookcases for $49. Plus great deals on bedroom sets, mattresses, dining, and so much more. Let Court's friendly furniture consultants help you find everything you need to live and work in comfort and style. With locations in Glendale on Central, in Corona at the 91 and McKinley, and now Fountain Valley at Euclid and the 405. Or go to CourtFurnitureOutlet.com. That's C-O-R-T FurnitureOutlet.com.
Life hacks. What would life be without them? Here's a life hack you may not have thought of. Using Allstate's low auto rates to save money. With Allstate, you can lower your rates, not your expectations. Visit Allstate.com or call an agent for a quote today.
I love a good movie or TV series, but it seems like every show has content that makes our family squirm, like profanity or graphic violence. That's why we use VidAngel, an amazing technology that lets us stream movies and TV with control over the content. VidAngel lets you customize the settings, so you can seamlessly skip and mute the hard stuff. So stop squirming and go to getvidangel.com. Use the code RADIO1 and you can try a month of VidAngel for only $1.
Has it been a while since you updated your social calendar? I know there are a lot of familiar faces I've missed over this past year. This is Ari Green of System Pavers, America's number one designer and installer of elegant outdoor living systems. As my family and I start reconnecting with more of our friends, we just want to set it up right. From planning fall get-togethers to living in the holiday season, a gorgeous outdoor space is an effortless way to bring people together again in style. If you're thinking about a new patio hangout spot or want to welcome guests with an impressive paver driveway, System Pavers makes it easy. And we'll help you save big during our Welcome Back Savings event. Act now to take advantage of low prices on driveways, patios, artificial turf, and more. Call 800-PAVE-004 right now. That's 800-PAVE-004. Better hurry, the savings won't last forever. 800-PAVE-004 or systempavers.com.
All orders must be placed by August 31st, and installation must commence within 60 days of sale. See website for full offer details. Contractor's license 661-575.
I think in a place like a radio station, we have pretty good reason to wipe down every
We've
surface.
We've been wiping down surfaces at radio stations since the dawn of time. Because we are a dirty people.
Right, Gary and Shannon.
Weekdays at 10 a.m.
Everybody, people who work in radio are gross.
On KFI.
Whoa, KFI AM 640 live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app.
Good morning, Bill Handel Show. We'll have an update on Bill's post-surgery situation at 9 o'clock, which may or may not include, on the phone, Bill Handel himself. Let's continue Handel on the News with Jennifer Jones Lee and me. President Biden has warned the nation's governors to help with the pandemic or get out of the way. And he's specifically meaning mostly Texas Governor Greg Abbott and Florida Governor Ron DeSantis. Because he's saying, hey, just between Texas and Florida, that's about a third of the new COVID cases. So they're the worst ones. And those are states where they are being very aggressive about, and I think this is fair to say, they're being very aggressive about preventing local authorities and or private businesses from deciding what they might want to do in terms of either mask rules or requiring vaccinations. So we definitely have a clash of basic governance ideas right now.
And even not just on local authorities. I just read this story about Texas Governor Abbott, who is saying that a judge doesn't have the authority to override, I think it was something like that. He put in, yesterday, he ruled that border protection should not transport people that they pick up at the border because of the potential of giving others COVID-19. They assume that the people who are showing up at the border haven't been vaccinated and therefore have the potential to spread. A judge overruled that. And then Greg Abbott said, no, you don't have the authority to overrule that because this isn't unconstitutional. I'm totally screwing this up, but you get my drift. In other words, the judge said no, Abbott said yes. And so I think he's trying to do it locally as well as he just wants to, like, put bumpers around his state. Let me do in Texas what I want to do. You can have the other 49.
He's punching down to the local authorities and wanting to control them, and he's punching up to the feds and wanting to somehow control them. Now, he has no authority to tell the feds what they're going to do. So that's a non-starter for him. Now, the other one, as the governor, can he issue an executive order preventing a city from issuing a mask mandate? It's a little trickier. But, you know, the people, politicians, where it's like, I don't want the feds telling me what to do. I should be able to decide what's best for my state. Well, I don't want the governor, I'm the mayor of Austin, I don't want the governor telling me what to do. I should be able to decide what's best for my city. And in the middle is Greg Abbott, and he goes, you feds leave me alone. Oh, mayor of Austin? Too bad for you. I will tell you what to do. So, hypocrisy at every turn, and on the other side, too, about this whole thing about how much big control from the top should there be versus how much should you let there be local control.
Yeah.
Right? And then it's just a matter of where does it stop? Right? So Greg Abbott wants it to stop at the governor's office. And the governor is the king of Texas. I don't know if that's legally correct or not correct or how that plays into the founding fathers, you know, view of these principles of federalism, that you would really let the states do as much of what they want to do as possible. That doesn't necessarily mean that the states have to let the cities.
Right.
It's sort of like the founding fathers said, we don't want a king. We don't want a king telling us what to do. We want to have this group of associated states. But they can all have kings. They can all have kings that completely control what goes on in their states. I don't know. Let's get another news update from Jennifer Jones Lee. It's KFI AM 640, live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app.
The Pacific Harbor Line Railroad Company is being sued by engineers at the ports of Long Beach and L.A. for alleged race discrimination, harassment, and a hostile work environment. The 7 current and former engineers are all Black. The company alleges the allegations are baseless. News is brought to you by Reuter Hero. A man's been shot and killed by police in Glendora. The L.A. County Sheriff's Department, which is helping in the investigation, says cops from Azusa shot the guy just after 1 this morning. The department says he was taken to the hospital where he was pronounced dead. President Biden says COVID-19 is a pandemic of the unvaccinated and is urging more Americans to get the shots.
Vaccinated people almost never are hospitalized with COVID-19. In fact, according to one recent study, 95% of overall COVID-19 hospitalizations are among those not fully vaccinated.
He says the Delta variant is highly contagious and is causing a new wave of cases. He says it accounts for over 80% of all COVID-19 cases in the U.S. today. He says the spread of the Delta variant is largely preventable, and the tragedy will get worse before it gets better. We were just talking about this story. Florida Governor Ron DeSantis says he's not going to put a mask mandate in place, and he's tired of all the judgment about it.
Nobody's trying to get ill here, okay? It's a very, you can, there's people that were hermits for a year and a half that wore 6 masks and did that and still contracted it, okay?
DeSantis says masks don't work and they won't help fight the current surge of COVID cases. Federal health officials say Florida is one of the states being impacted by the Delta variant the most. And the Titanic iceberg has claimed some more victims.
Officials at the Titanic Museum attraction in Tennessee say the iceberg wall display collapsed and injured 3 people. The museum's owners say Monday was an accident and the museum was open the next day. The museum opened in 2010 and is half the size of the original Titanic. The interactive iceberg wall on the promenade deck allowed visitors to touch the ice, but it, like the real iceberg, is now gone. No word on the condition of the injured guests. The museum's owners say it'll take at least 4 weeks for the iceberg to be rebuilt. Michael Crozier, KFI News.
I'm driven by that. It actually looks pretty cool from the outside. I've never been inside, and apparently I'm glad I wasn't yesterday. Let's take a look at your job now, Jeff Boss, going back to the 101 again.
I'm happy for you, too.
Yeah, yikes.
All right. West San Fernando Valley, got to give you a heads up, though. We left this a little while ago, but if you just joined us, westbound 101 before Winnetka, there was quite a vehicle fire. As a matter of fact, it was a truck, was ablaze, and fire department was out there, big numbers. Now, slight improvement, we left it just a few minutes ago. It was only 2 right instead of the 3 right being blocked, but it was real, real slow now coming away from Winnetka. Now, I'd like to think they're cleaning up and pretty much done by now, but the backup is going to stay there for a while. If you get off and use Ventura Boulevard, even with the signals, it was still good. Get on or back on the West 101 at Winnetka, or even Topanga, if you will, and you'll be around all of us and on your way. Eastbound side, by the way, Thousand Oaks into the San Fernando Valley, looking good, stays that way to the 405 to the 101. If you do make the right turn now and pick up the South 101 Hollywood Freeway, be careful going uphill. Another fire department routine here. There's a fire in a parking lot, so the fire department's on the right shoulder, so just be careful as you go by. But up and over the hill, things are pretty good. And again, the East LA interchange, well, we're headed there now, but it's kind of that West 10 North 101 merge. They're kind of typical stuff going up towards the 4 level. North into the valley, at least that side's looking real good. Injured in an accident, visit Superwoman, superlawyer.com. Jeff Bond, KFI in the sky.
Hey, some big news. Eric Bolling is back on TV with a new show. Tune in to Newsmax every weekday at 1 p.m. Pacific and watch Eric Bolling on The Balance. Eric is The Balance, the big media, woke politics, and cancel culture. All this week, Eric's exposing the dangers of Joe Biden's inflation. It's already rising and it could devalue your stocks, bonds, cash, and even your retirement. So get the truth about Biden and find your balance. Watch Eric Bolling on Newsmax at noon. More than 30 million Americans watch Newsmax. It's on all major cable systems. If your operator doesn't carry it, you got to call them. Tell them you want it. Plus, Newsmax is free on streaming systems like Roku, Samsung, LG, Pluto, Zumo, and more. Or download the free Newsmax app on your phone, and then you can watch it anytime, anywhere. More than 30 million Americans are tuning into Newsmax because it's real news for real people.
SoCal weather from KFI, sunny today and hot once again, with highs in the 70s at the beaches. We'll make it into the mid-80s, maybe a few upper 80s for metro LA and Orange County. Otherwise, we'll be in the mid-90s to low 100s again for the valleys and the IE. We lead local, live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. I'm Jennifer Jones Lee.
Spectrum Business called their competitors to see if any of them could beat Spectrum's Business Internet Plus phone offer for $69.98 per month with no added phone taxes or fees. Here are real quotes from the competition.
How are they pulling in no fees and taxes? That's madness.
I would 100% go with Spectrum.
Even the competition recommends Spectrum Business. Call 855-339-5344 and switch to Spectrum Business today.
Competitor quotes from actual phone conversations. Limited time offer, restrictions apply. Call for details.
Hey, this is Mo Kelly from KFI AM 640. You've heard that the COVID-19 vaccines are effective. Now let's talk about how they actually work. Think of the vaccine as a boot camp for your immune system. It imitates COVID-19 so that your body can learn to fight it. If you're exposed to the real virus in the future, your immune system will know how to protect you. So let's get you vaccinated. Let's get to immunity. Visit myturn.ca.gov to find walk-in sites near you or call 833-422-4255. Brought to you by the California Department of Public Health.
With Stater Brothers Family of Brands, get A-plus deals on back-to-school essentials. From Craven breakfast sandwiches to Simply Done snack bags, we've got you covered. Because if you can't tell the difference, why pay the difference? Back-to-school savings from Stater Brothers Markets.
Hey, it's Gary Hoffman. Let's talk about your Medicare coverage. SCAN Health Plan is for people with Medicare. Now more than ever, it's important to have comprehensive coverage when you need it most. If you're new to Medicare, have both Medicare and Medi-Cal, or have been diagnosed with certain chronic conditions, you may qualify to enroll in SCAN now. Call SCAN at 1-855-370-7226, TTY711, or ask your agent about SCAN.
SCAN Health Plan is an HMO plan with a Medicare contract. Enrollment in SCAN Health Plan depends on contract renewal.
Hey, DQ fans, the chocolate and peanut butter in your favorite Reese's candy is taken to a whole new level in the Reese's Extreme Blizzard Treat. Reese's Peanut Butter Cups, Reese's Pieces, chocolatey topping, extra peanut butter, and world-famous soft serve. Grab it today, only at DQ. Happy tastes good.
Termite problems? Search PacificCoastTermite.com or call 800-PACIFIC.
For official rules and more information about contests on this station, go to KFIAM640.com/rules. KFI AM 640.
An iHeartRadio station.
24-hour news. More stimulating talk.
Post-surgery recovery at 9. And if he can, he will call in. Let's do some more handle on the news. Jennifer Jones Lee and me.
All right. Majority of New York State lawmakers have said, you know what, Governor Cuomo, you need to resign after that investigation concluded that you did, in fact, sexually harass 11 women. And Governor Cuomo said, what was it you did earlier?
He went.
Yeah. And even President Biden waded into this and said, remember what I said in March about what if these allegations were true that he needed to resign, and just re-upped that and said, I stand by what I said in March. And again, I feel like Governor Cuomo said, oh, do you see all these birds flying around the room? Yeah, I'm flipping them to you. He's not, his indignation and defiance of these allegations against him, and the fact that yesterday when he came out and tried to flip it and make it political. I mean, he said something about politics is woven in this, and how, I mean, it was gross to me to listen to him somehow was he intimating that these 11 women who came forward were Republican plants, and that they just were hopeful that he would grab their butts or brush against them or whatever? I mean, that's what it felt like. Like, how dare he not even say, like, apologize in some way, or instead he puts up pictures of him kissing people on the cheek, both men and women, and saying, this is just the way I was raised to be respectful. Oh, please.
Yeah, I can't tell with him. I'm still unclear whether a lot of this is, because he said also something about the facts portrayed in the report are not what really happened. So he's saying on the one hand, I didn't do these things, but his other argument is, I do this kind of stuff all the time.
I kiss everybody.
Wait, so you do it all the time, but nobody should be upset about it, or you didn't do it?
To these particular 11
women. He's in the last treading water, blind panic mode of a political career, okay? Because he's got now the majority of his own state's lawmakers want him to step down, and he also has he's now being criminally investigated over the same stuff. And At 7 o'clock, we can get into all the mishigas with him and his brother on CNN.
Yes.
And how, boy oh boy, talk about abdicating your journalistic integrity with that situation too. So I think this is the sputter before his career is over.
And do you remember at the start of the pandemic, Governor Cuomo, this is before all the nursing home thing, he was holding those news conferences every day and in many ways became Governor COVID.
Yeah.
And now look, I mean, in what, 18 months?
Egomaniacs,
yeah.
Man.
Yeah.
They're not every politician is an egomaniac. But some of them are. And for some reason, we get them here in California a lot. And they got one in their governor in New York. He is a full-on narcissist. So he was like, I'm going to be the king of the pandemic.
Yep.
Even while they were having some of the worst case rates and death rates, you know. But whatever, he's shameless. Hold on. I did not just say he has. I retract he has. Okay?
Okay.
Totally retracted. Completely new sentence I'm about to speak. I personally believe that some politicians are so narcissistic and egotistical that they border on being antisocial personality in that they absolutely do not care how hypocritical their rhetoric is, how much flip-flopping they do, or how much just flat-out outrageous stuff they say with a straight face. It's a very general observation, not about anybody in particular. And certainly not an assertion of fact. It is rather an opinion. And also, I will point out, I'm doing all of this for the lawyers. I will also point out, I'm not basing my opinion on claiming to have any behind-the-scenes information that I'm not sharing with you. I'm basing my opinion on only what has been publicly reported about whoever you might assume wrongly that I'm even thinking about when I say these things.
You just holler when you want me to come in there and take that blanket off your butt, because you just did a CYA like I've never heard.
I got 10 blankets on my butt now, baby. Do not pull that out as a drop, Tyler. Don't you dare. I do not want to hear myself saying I got 10 blankets on my butt now, baby, ever again.
And I get to hear yourself say it twice.
Oh, speaking of generally what I was just talking about, Governor Newsom in the news. He is suing to prevent the people who are behind the recall effort against him from saying in their advertising and their pamphlets that the recall effort against him is being led by Republicans and Trump supporters. I'm sorry. I got it backwards. It's the people in the recall campaign who are suing Newsom to stop him from saying that. That makes more sense, doesn't it? Because Newsom is saying, these Republicans and Trump people, that's all this is, Republicans and Trump people. So the people behind it are saying, you can't say that. That's not true because not everybody involved in it is a Republican, blah, 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 blah. So it's not accurate. And here's the thing, though, they're going to lose. They're going to lose because this is all political speech pursuant to a campaign. And the courts just don't get involved in trying to regulate the, quote, truth or falsity of campaign rhetoric. Imagine if they did.
Oh.
Can you imagine if every time there was a campaign speech, a campaign ad, a campaign mailer, and it said something that, like, you could make the case that that's not really true and sue them and win, there'd be no campaigning anymore. Campaigns are purposefully based on stuff that gets either right up to the line of being false or is actually false.
I feel like you'd have to have a separate branch of the courts. Criminal courts. civil courts and political courts.
Campaign speech. That's never going to happen. The First Amendment, basically, things you can say as part of a campaign, you have a lot more latitude than things you could say in an advertisement for an energy drink or in a newspaper article about a prominent businessman. This is the way it is. So it's not going to go anywhere.
All right, I'm just going to tease this one really fast because you're going to talk more about it in 45 minutes with Steve Gregory. But we've had sort of an after-action report when it comes to the cleanup of Echo Park, and it wasn't completely flattering to the LAPD. Talks about a lot of failures on the parts of politicians and agencies, and it also talks specifically, I thought, that the allegations against Lhasa and its refusal to cooperate with the city and then this nonprofit that came in and did more than Lhasa has done in like a year when it comes to placing people in permanent housing, I thought was really eye-opening. So I know you'll get into the details with Steve.
Oh, yeah, at 7:30. And right now we'll get a news update from Jennifer Jones-Lee. It's KFI AM 640, live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app.
A woman accusing New York Governor Cuomo of sexual misconduct says he should be impeached if he won't resign. An independent investigation found that he sexually harassed multiple women. The governor of Texas claims there's not enough evidence to stop his new COVID-19 executive order to make it illegal to provide ground transportation to migrants detained by Border Patrol to protect his people from COVID-19, but a judge halted the order, saying it conflicts with federal immigration law. And former President Obama turned 60 today. He was planning to throw a big party this weekend at his vacation home on Martha's Vineyard, but that reportedly has been canceled. As you remember, Obama took a lot of heat for holding such a big party during a nationwide surge of cases of COVID-19. We've got to look at your drive with BKFI in the Sky in the 5 next.
Did you know that the average American has 97 points they can add to their credit score, but they have no idea how to get them? The data scientists at Scoremaster cracked the code on how to do it. Adding 97 points to your credit score is like found money. It also means fast loan approvals, huge discounts, and low interest rates on everything from buying or refinancing a home to leasing a new car to applying for a credit card. How fast is Scoremaster? One member raised his credit score 33 points in just 5 days. Another person, 43 points in just a couple weeks. And we get tremendous feedback from listeners just like you about Scoremaster. Scoremaster is so easy, it takes about a minute to get started. And if you're in a hurry, you get to try Scoremaster for free. That's right, try Scoremaster for free and see how many plus points you can add to your credit score. Just go to scoremaster.com/Tim. That's scoremaster.com/Tim. scoremaster.com/Tim.
At Whole Foods Market, enjoy an epic grill night with seafood. Get sustainable wild-caught previously frozen Chilean sea bass fillets for 20% off through August 10th while supplies last. Plus, Prime members save an extra 10%. Learn more on the Whole Foods Market app.
SoCal weather from KFI, sunny with highs 70s at the coast to the low 100s inland. This report is brought to you by Whole Foods Market. Let's check out your drive on the 5.
You betcha. Well, the East LA Interchange doesn't always get a flattering report, but it's doing its best right now. Just want to explain a little bit of stuff, especially going north. North 5 to North 5 through the East LA Interchange. It is quite slow. It starts around the 710. Complicating that transition was a crash right in the middle going North 5 to North 5. As you make the transition, you'll see a couple of cars over to the right shoulder now. So that's what that's all about. And incoming southbound, all freeways, and then going to the South 5, for Indiana, another shoulder problem there. That's what it's all about. To Orange County, real quick, South 5 at Brookhurst, south of 91. A little bit of an issue there, causing a little slowing. Then you'll find some more around the 22 and the 55, kind of normal stuff. The big westbound 210 drive, San Dimas to Pasadena. Right now, it's okay. It's a little slow, especially the transition north 57, west 210 and all that. A little slow at San Anita, not too bad. Northbound 605 around Downey at the 105. Be careful if you're in the right lane. CHP and a rig barely to the shoulder. Be careful going by. Injured in an accident, visit superwomansuperlawyer.com. Jeff Baugh, KFI in the Sky.
This report is sponsored by Discover. Discover matches all the cash back you earn on your credit card at the end of your first year. It's amazing because Discover is accepted at 99% of places in the U.S. that take credit cards. Learn more at discover.com/yes. 2021 Nielsen report, limitations apply.
Let's face it, painting your house is a pain in the you know what. It's time consuming, it's expensive, and what's worse, you have to repaint every few years because nowadays paint is basically just colored water. Hi, I'm Steve, creator of Deluxe Life Coat, and we're here to take the pain out of painting. Deluxe Life Coat is a revolutionary exterior coating that comes in any color you like. It's 20 times thicker than paint. More importantly, it's a permanent solution to the never-ending cycle of painting and repainting. Deluxe Life Coat has the best lifetime warranty in the industry. It covers flaking, peeling, and yes, even cracking. What paint can say that? Take the pain out of painting with Deluxe Life Coat. Call Deluxe Life Coat right now and get 20% off and pay no interest for 2 years. 800-947-5500. 800-947-5500. That's 800-947-5500 or visit DeluxeLifeCoat.com.
Certain terms and conditions apply. CSLB number 774518.
Hey, Gary, how are things?
Things are great, but I crushed my mortgage payment with Oni without even leaving my couch. I got a no closing cost refi at a great low rate, and Oni did it all in less than 3 weeks. It was easy, no muss, no fuss.
Be like Gary. Call Oni at 855-5-ONI and crush your mortgage payment with today's 30-year fixed refi at 2.625% rated APR with no closing costs. None. Zero. Even if you've refinanced recently, call 855-5-ONI and let us crush your monthly payment even more. That's 855-5-ONI or log on to owning.com.
NMLS 2611, licensed by the Department of Financial Protection and Innovation under the California Residential Mortgage Lending Act, subject to credit approval. Call 823-852-6464 for terms and conditions.
You can crush it too with a 30-year fixed 2.625% rate in APR with absolutely no closing costs.
Contact your license 1047781.
In the air conditioner marathon, you run till you drop. You can't fix it by just unplugging it and plugging it in again. Your AC is working its heart out for you. Your AC needs some TLC. Tender love and care. It needs a gentle rejuvenation. Rejuvenation. We're going to bring that air conditioner back to life. Gettle will bring six critical systems back to factory specs and wash those outside coals the right way, not the easy way. Your home will feel cooler, but your AC will be working a lot less hard and using a lot less energy. It only costs $129. What only costs $129? Rejuvenation. Rejuvenation. If your rejuvenated system breaks down before the end of the year, I'm going to give you $500 off a new five-star system. Gettle. TTL. We'll keep you cool, but it's hard to spell.
Attention savvy investors. Are you looking to hedge against inflation and receive steady monthly cash flow? How about the safety and security of a real estate investment without the hassles of being a landlord? Maybe you should cash out of some stock market risk and volatility and take some money off the table. Instead, receive 10% annualized monthly payouts with bonuses targeted to 21%. NRIA is an industry-leading real estate development firm in its 15th year constructing strategically located, lower-risk, high-demand properties in unique neighborhoods based on supply-demand imbalance. Call 800-800-1414 to start your due diligence. A great fit for safety-oriented investors desiring monthly cash flow and diversification into carefully curated real estate. Learn more about the NRIA Real Estate Development Fund at NRIA.net or call 800-800-1414. That's 800-800-1414.
An offer of securities is only made by the NRIA Private Placement Memorandum. Read it first. Past performance does not guarantee future results. NRIA is a real estate development firm. Learn more at NRIA.net.
Prices are out of control. There was a neighborhood restaurant that we used to go to.
And a pasta dish was like $14, $15, right?
The same dish is now $28. I don't pay $28 for pasta unless someone else is paying. I just don't. 28!
John and Ken.
Al. Weekdays at 2.
Food inflation.
On KFI.
Live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app. Good morning, Bill Handel's show. We'll have an update on Bill's post-surgery condition at 9. Let's finish up Handel on the news now. Jennifer Jones Lee and me, firefighters fighting a brush fire in Mount Baldy area. I guess a vehicle caught on fire. So the stuff around the vehicle caught on fire. And it grew from 10 acres to about 50 acres quickly. The good news is it's kind of in the middle of the forest. It's not near any homes or any structures, and also it's burning uphill. Now, I don't know that area well enough to say if it's burning uphill, it's probably burning away from the direction where you would eventually get to homes, unless there's like some guy with a house way up at the peak. So that part's good. No containment at this time, apparently, but they are on it. There's firefighters there. They're dropping water on it.
By the way, I did just check out the Dixie Fire, the one in Butte and Plumas.
Yeah.
That one's just getting worse. They had to evacuate another 15,000 people because it jumped the perimeters that the firefighters had created. And then they've got hot, dry conditions up there today.
Uh-huh.
And 40-mile-an-hour winds predicted for today and tomorrow.
Oh, no, no, no. Well, that's going to be... I mean, does this become another campfire?
I hope not. At least they're getting people out.
Right.
Part of the problem with the campfire was how quickly it got in there, and it was one way in and one way out, and they couldn't get people evacuated fast enough. So hopefully we don't run into that. All right, here's a story that I want to delve a little deeper into this week on Wake Up Call. But the drought has prompted California to limit some water diversions. So the diversion specifically is from California water regulators, and they say farmers will have to stop taking waters from major reservoirs, or rivers and streams, because of the drought. And this will let regulators stop water diversions from the state's two biggest river systems, Sacramento and the San Joaquin. But the things I want to talk about is I want to go, and I'm trying to get Morgan actually to get somebody from, say, the California Almond Association or something like that on. Because we know that almonds are one of the crops specifically that take the most water to produce. But as you're driving up and down the 5, there are these billboards, and I've told you about them before. It's a little boy scratching his head, and he says, "Is growing food wasting water?" And that's one of the things that I want to ask these farmers is, as these water reductions come, A, how much can they actually handle? B, how many of these crops are going fallow, or how many of them are they having to just turn over and say, just going to wait a year or two or whatever? Or C, are they able to keep their crops, but how much are we going to see a shrinkage of those crops and those prices go up? So are we going to see huge prices, not like nuts aren't already super expensive, but a huge increase in things like almonds next year?
Which then sort of the economy may mediate this problem. If the price of almonds goes up enough, people will stop buying almonds, and then there won't be a demand, and then they'll have to find another crop to grow.
Or, and honestly, to be fair to the water regulators, are there places where the farmers could trim some of their water pork, if you will?
Mm-hmm.
Are there places where things are being wasted? I don't know. I don't know the answer to any of that, which is why I want to delve deeper.
Where are the pot people...
Who are stealing
to well, there's that problem. The illegal pot growers are stealing water. But where are the I'll call, say, legitimate cannabis growers to advise all these other agricultural industries about possible ways to do it with less water?
Yeah, that's a great idea.
I mean, here's what you have to do. This is a major problem, right? So I don't think it's fair to just go, sorry, farmers, you're not going to have any water. Figure out what else you're going to do with your life.
Right.
That seems unfair. But you have to do something. You have to do everything. So your point, first thing you do is look at waste. Because nobody can have a problem with stopping the use of water that isn't helping anything, that's literally just being wasted. You go there first. Number two, you go to everybody who has any involvement in growing anything, and you try to pool all the ideas for growing the same amount of crops with less water. Then maybe, if you can't get some movement on the problem there, then maybe you start to look at having to, unfortunately, take somebody's livelihood away from them and help them get a different livelihood. In other words, growing something that doesn't require so much water. But here they're sort of starting off with, hey, you're just not going to be able to have water. Okay, let's get a news update from Jennifer Jones Lee, and then Governor Andrew Cuomo of New York in hot water. People want him to resign. He's under criminal investigation. The attorney general came out with a scathing report saying he's basically a dirtbag. Is that fair?
That's very fair.
In the sexual harassment and unwanted the interactions department. Now it turns out the whole thing with him and his brother, who's a prominent media person, is tighter than we might even have imagined. This is KFI AM 640 live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app.
It's hard to keep track of everything that's going on. Luckily, that's a little hobby of ours.
KFI.
And KOST HD2.
Los Angeles, Orange County.
Live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app.
Slight uptick in a specific place. I'm Jennifer Jones-Lee, live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. LA County's latest COVID-19 numbers show a small increase in cases at skilled nursing facilities, even though there are high rates of vaccination rates among residents and staff. Data out yesterday showed there are 33 new cases for the week ending July 18th. That's up from 22 the week before. County officials blame the Delta variant for the increase, as well as a small number of breakthrough infection of vaccinated people. They say getting vaccinated is still the best defense against COVID. California water regulators, as we were just talking, say some farmers will have to stop taking water from major rivers and streams because of the severe drought. The Water Resources Control Board has approved an emergency resolution that lets regulators stop water diversions from the state's two biggest river systems, the Sacramento and the San Joaquin. The new rule will start in 2 weeks. Public health officials say this year's first case of West Nile virus in L.A. County has been confirmed. The health department says a person from South Bay had the virus at the end of last month. There are no vaccines or medications for West Nile virus. A couple of families say the LAPD bomb squad explosion in South L.A. contributed to the deaths of two elderly relatives. They say the two men had underlying health conditions and were evacuated from their homes without their oxygen supply. They also stress the stress of the explosion on top of eating unhealthy city-provided meals and sugary snacks were contributing factors in the deaths of the men. LAPD Chief Moore told the police commission yesterday the department is not responsible for those deaths. The explosion June 30th injured 17 people and caused major damage to homes and businesses. A report from the LAPD shows inaction on the part of city leaders led to that mass eviction of a homeless camp in Echo Park.
The 100-page summary claims neglect by politicians and city agencies contributed to the problems back in March when the LAPD was forced to remove people from 200 tents and cost the city more than $1 million in repairs to the park. The report also notes the city-county homeless agency known as LASA did not cooperate with city officials and should have been able to clear the park. Instead, the city had to pay $350,000 to Urban Alchemy, nonprofit hired to facilitate housing for the homeless in the park. The report also concluded Urban Alchemy housed more people in 3 months than LASA did in 1 year. Steve Gregory, KFI News.
And Steve will delve deeper into that report with Wayne coming up at 7:30. Advocates have gathered in Costa Mesa to demand federal funding for forever chemicals, which they say have seeped into the water in OC.
Groups say the cancer-causing chemicals come from things like cleaning supplies, Teflon, firefighting foam, and food packing materials.
30% of our groundwater wells have been shut down because of PFAS contamination.
Former Congressman Harley Ruta says the county does have a new treatment plant,
but who's paying for it? The polluters aren't paying for it.